The other day I saw somebody searching for an email inside their Microsoft Outlook, and they had a file structure where they're looking through different folders that they've set up and placed emails into. So I suggested using search inside Microsoft Outlook to find what they're looking for, and they did type it in, but it returned a lot of different emails and still didn't find that specific one. So I mentioned that you can go even deeper and more specific inside Microsoft Outlook for a search, and that's what I want to show you here today on Teacher's Tech. Hi, my name is Jamie and welcome to Teachers Tech. If you're looking for other Microsoft Outlook tutorials, I'll put the link to my playlist down below in the description, then you can check out some other things if you're just learning. But let's talk about search inside Microsoft Outlook. I am using Office 365 for this demo here. And to get to search, if you look at the very top, you'll see the search. As soon as I click in search or just hover over top, you're gonna see there's some shortcuts there. It says Control plus E or Alt plus Q to open up the search. So I'm just gonna go ahead and click in search and it opens up this dropdown. And what it's saying, these are some ones that I've recently searched for. So if you wanna search for them again, they've just put them right there because they know that they're common what you've looked for. What I'm going to just do is click off to the side, and you can see since I've clicked in that search, it's opened up the search tab. I can go ahead and close this if I want right away by clicking here. Now, I just want to talk about where it defaults first. So if you're looking for a specific email, this is defaults to the current mailbox that you're in. So if you know if your email you're looking for is in a different mailbox, you'll need to switch to that. You can switch to that mailbox and do the search. Or what you could do is go all mailboxes. And this defaults to current mailbox. You can actually change this, and I'll show you how to make those changes in some of the options at the end of this video. So this is the first part where I'd be looking for, especially if you have a structure inside your email already with organization, with folders and subfolders, because you can go to those folders and then go and look specifically through a current folder, a subfolder, or if you're looking for everything, go ahead and look all Outlook items because you haven't maybe categorized it through one of your folders. You can look for everything. So this would be the first place I would stop to start narrowing down your email search. So let's say you've gone through your scope here of all the different folders or mailboxes that it might be in, still can't find it. So maybe you're afraid that you've deleted this. You can just select this right here. So if I click on this, notice how it's grayed out around. That means it's going to include the deleted items in your search. All right, let's do a little test search real quickly here. If I wanted to look for an order of something, so I could type an order, and nothing comes up with my current mailbox, I can switch it over to my all mailboxes, and then I get a highlight for those words, so I have multiple ones. So you can see how a kind of a basic search works. Let's say if I'm looking from a specific person, and I'm going to go over here and refine this, and I'll stay in all mailboxes, so I'll just go, I'm going to clear this by clicking this X here, and notice it just clears out. I'm going to go from a sender. So I'm going to say from, and it comes up with sender name. And this is where I can write in the name. So I'll put in my name and I'll just search for there. And it comes back in all mailboxes. You can see there's this many. Now I can go a little bit more specific here. If I go in subject and maybe I'll type in hello because I know that's one of the subjects. And I'll type hello, and it gives me back the specific email that I'm looking for. Now, I could even go more specific if I had, let's say, hundreds of these emails still, and I knew there was attachments connected to this, I could go ahead and just click attachment. And this one does have an attachment, so it's showing. But if you know that it does have an attachment, you can go ahead and click on this. I'm going to go ahead and clear this search result here. And just go back to it. And now I just want to talk about some of these others to refine. And if you are the type of person that you're taking advantage of the categorized colors and flagging and important markers, this can really be helpful when finding your emails. So if I'm looking for, and I'll go to all mailboxes, you can search for a certain categorized color. I'll just give this an example. You can see this has a categorization here, so it shows. So if you are adding those things to your emails, it will help you later on, even when finding your email. So that's something you can do prior to even getting to the search stage. We do have a few more options here. I'm just going to close out of this. And just taking a look at the refine. Look, we have the sent to. Now you can set, do you want to find things that are sent to me or CC to me, not sent directly to me or sent to another recipient? So notice as I hover over any of these, it gives that information so it can specifically show you, help you understand what you're looking for. So that's a little bit about refining in your search to find specifically what you're looking for. So I just want to point out advanced search to you. Now I'm going to go back up to the search bar here and notice that over to the right, I have a drop down, and this is going to be your advanced search. So if I go ahead, click on it, and you can see this is where I can also do a search. So I could change the mailbox or the folder or the change it, just like the different ways I've showed you. I can go through here and quickly kind of click on all the different things that I want, where I could say it has an attachment, and I can click on, and I can write some information this attachment contains. I could put my from in here, anything in the body of the email that I could do a search for. Received, if I know I got it between a certain time period, I could put the start date to the end date, subject, the to, and I could add more options. So if I go ahead and click on this, you can see we have more options that we can just select, and that will add. So if I was going to say, I'll say BCC and categories and apply it. Now, if you notice, I have BCC and categories that I can search for through. So you can create this advanced search. So this might be a quicker way to for you to find and kind of specifically make it the way that you want, that you can just go through and click on the certain options that you've set. Now, I would just want to go through some of the options of setting up your search and how you can make some changes, like I mentioned at the beginning. All right, now let's get to the options. Now, the first thing I just want to point out, notice how I moved the scope to here, and I'm going to show you how you can set these up in a different order if you want to. But there's a couple different ways you can go to options. In mine right now, I have search tools here. Oh, I'll go back to it. I have search tools, I'll drop down, and I have search options, and it brings me to this. Now, if you don't have that, where you can go, if you go back to file to the very beginning here, and you can see options at the very bottom here. And then if I go to search, I have some options I can change. Now, I mentioned this before, right now it defaults to the current folder. So current mailbox when searching from the inbox, you can change that to all mailboxes if you wanted it to default there. And if you go through, you can kind of check different ones on and off. Do you want to include messages from deleted items in each folder when searching? So this is turned off right now. Do you want a different color search highlighted? So I had yellow. When I looked for order, it came up with yellow. You can change that. So those are just some of the options that you can change in it. Now, I want to point out in your custom ribbon here. So, and then I'm going to go over to the right here and click where it says main tabs. I'm going to go to tool tabs and notice that we have search right here. So I'm just going to open this up and we have scope, refine, results, options, close. I can change the order of these. So I moved up scope. I can just click and drag these around and change. So right now I have results. If I hit OK, I have results first. So you can change the order that you want for these. So I hope this search tutorial today in Microsoft Outlook has given you a little bit of help with it because we can get thousands and thousands of emails and we don't always remember to categorize them the way we want. So let me know what else you're looking for that I can help you with some tech tutorials. Thanks for watching this week on Teachers Tech. I'll see you next time with more tech tips and tutorials.